This is a 190 Q&A practice test. Plaintiff attorney, Mr. Ryan, capital R-Y-A-N. Defense attorney, Mr. Davis, capital D-A-V-I-S. And we'll start with plaintiff attorney. Ready? Here we go. All right, now when you went to that area you described as the flat area, Mr. Graves, what did you do from there? We then proceeded on foot down this kind of grassy, overgrown gravel and dirt road, and this is the pond. Goes around the pond, and you can sort of see cars lined up along the edge of the road that goes around the pond. Right about there, a little more than halfway down to the pond, there was a, I'm going to show you a close-up there, just so you know, sir, this exhibit, as previously identified, was taken after the car was removed. All right, but for purposes of showing the area and the path you took, if you would now demonstrate with the pointer what you did. All right, so this is the flat level area. That's the car crusher. We proceeded down this road to right there. All right, thank you. There's a red car and two white cars. The Mustang was a blue car, was parked parallel to the red car. Its nose was facing this direction. And the record should reflect he directly pointed to a westerly direction. The record will so reflect. All right, very well. Thank you, Mr. Graves. If you would please then describe further the line of cars and the particular Mustang that you examined or just observed. Okay, these cars parked along here were kind of older looking. The paint was faded. They looked like they belonged there in the salvage yard. The Mustang looked a little different. It was shiny and it had an old Rambler hood leaned up against it. The back panel. It had a piece of plywood up against the front end on the side. It had several tree branches up against the back, had a cardboard box sitting on the hood, and had quite a large 12 to 15 foot tall tree that kind of looked like it had been ripped out of the ground, still had roots attached, was leaning up against and over the hood. The other vehicles there had been parked there, and there were saplings growing up around them, but this one had detached tree limbs and things around it. The Rambler hood and some fence posts were leaned up against the car. The other cars didn't have that sort of stuff around them. The car was sitting there and there was vegetation growing up around them, so it looked a little odd. All right, and before we go further, tell us about the weather conditions upon your arrival. When I first got the call at noon, I was informed that the weather was threatening. It was nearly November. It was kind of cold, but it was rain that we were having. It had rained and they were afraid that it was going to rain on the car. I advised them they should cover it in some way if they could because of the rain. If there were fingerprints or anything, handprints and the dust on the car, that would get rinsed away by the rainwater. So I believe they had put a tarp over the car when it did begin to rain, and they had removed the tarp just as we arrived. It wasn't raining when we arrived, but it was still dark and cloudy. And during my course of my stay there that evening, at times it did. We had an actual thunderstorm, and that flat area then I talked about, I can remember stepping out of the van at one point into a puddle, not just a puddle, but the general area where the water was pretty deep, and we had quite a torrent of rain. Let the record reflect the witness put his hands together and gave us an apparent estimate of what looked like about 4 to 6 inches of water, 2 to 3 inches of standing water. Now, as you arrived to examine this vehicle, was it raining at that exact point? Maybe misting wasn't really raining. How long before it began to rain relative to daylight, darkness? I believe it was just after dark that it really started to pour. The lightning was very dramatic. All right, now directing your attention more specifically to the Mustang, what was the condition of the car itself? Describe its appearance in addition to the camouflage materials you already talked about, but what else about the car can you tell us? Well, it was newer looking. I examined all the items that were around it. The thought there, if somebody put them there, they had to have touched them somehow. You know, the tree branches, there may have been places where something would snag on it, maybe be some clothing fibers. If there was any blood involved, there might be blood stains on them. I looked at them for that sort of material. I didn't find any. The cardboard box and the Rambler hood, I thought, had surfaces that maybe would hold fingerprints if you had touched it with your fingers. It was a smooth enough surface that it would hold a latent print, so I decided to collect those and return those to the lab, and we were going to return the Mustang to the lab. We couldn't get into the car. All the doors were locked, so the extent of my examination of the inside was shining a flashlight through the windows and just looking inside. All right, and how much time did you say you spent looking inside the car with a flashlight? Oh, there were several of us around the car at that time looking inside. Once all the materials had been removed from around it, that was pretty much the first time anyone could get, you know, close enough to peer inside. All right, let me ask you then, what were you looking for or trying to see when you examined inside the car? Well, it was a missing persons case, so the first thing I wanted to know was the missing person inside the missing person's car, and I didn't see any evidence of that. All right, now before we go any further, I would like to direct your attention to the screen again showing you exhibit 130 and ask, does that scene strike any memories with you? Yes, that's me standing there, right there. That's the Mustang, and that's a bit of a fence post. That's the Rambler hood. That's a piece of plywood. This is part of the tree that was against the front end, and those are bits of the branches that were against the back end. And who is that in the red coat? That's Special Agent Tom Rice. And what does he have under his arm? I can't quite make that out. Kind of looks like he is holding a tarp. A tarp. What exhibit is that, counsel? 130. And the gentleman immediately behind Agent Rice is whom? That's Ben Lee. That's my photographer. All right, thank you. The car you said you saw, you were looking for evidence of a person. Was there anything else you were looking for at that point? Not really. Could you describe the ease or difficulty it was to see if the car when you were working with the flashlight? Well, at that point, the glass was wet from the rain. There was a lot of glare, so you kind of had to, you know, get the light and not have it bounce right back in your face. You can see the front windows are clear, but the back windows were all tinted, so it was kind of hard to see through that, to see what was in the back end. How many people were flashing flashlights into the back of that car? I think there were at least two of us, because I was looking through the side and I could see another light moving around inside the car, and there was somebody standing on the opposite side of the car. Now, as you were, how much time would you say you spent looking into the car? Oh, probably not more than 5 or 10 minutes. During that time, did you see any evidence of any blood in the car? No, I didn't. All right. Were there any license plates on the car? No, the license plates had been removed. Did you notice whether there was any damage to the car at all? Yes, once we got the debris away from it, there was a scratch behind the Rambler hood, and then this front end had a little bit of collision damage. The lens on the light was cracked or broken, and there was some denting to the window. Did you examine the debris that was on the car for the presence of any trace or biological evidence? Yes, I did. And what did you find? I didn't see anything that I felt was unusual. I didn't see any blood stain. I didn't see any hairs affixed to anything. I didn't see any fibers attached to any of it. All right, the word list. Mr. Graves, capital G-R-A-V-E-S. Mustang, capital M-U-S-T-A-N-G. Rambler, capital R-A-M-B-L-E-R. Tom Rice, capital T-O-M, new word, capital R-I-C-E. Ben Lee, capital B-E-N, new word, capital L-E-E. And that is it for the word list. And that will conclude our 190 Q&A practice test.